All right, guys, welcome to the last and final step here for exporting from Grasshopper into Design Explorer. This will be a pretty quick one. So first things first, we have exported all of our images here, which is great. And we have the options.json file that you can download from the syllabus. We've dropped that into our folder. All of this is under C drive Design Explorer data into our unique project directory. And we have the streaming .csv. This is what has run out of our Grasshopper file here. So one thing you'll notice is the final iteration has recorded the final iteration has been recorded twice. It's been recorded once at the beginning and then once at the end. And that's a consequence of a bit of a glitch in Grasshopper because we need to start our animation at the end in order to capture the image of the zero iteration. The data recorder is going to record the data from wherever the animation slider started, in this case at the end. So it's just annoying. All you have to do is delete it. And remember, you have to save your CSV, save it as data.csv. And you always want to do that immediately after your simulation run is complete so that you don't risk overwriting it. So now in this folder, I have this streaming CSV, which is fine. We're just going to leave it alone. It's okay if it gets overwritten. Doesn't matter. We've got our options.json. We have all of our images saved out as PNGs. And we have our data.csv. So, all right, next, open the command line from within the Design Explorer folder. So this is, again, like a little bit of a hacky, weird computer science thing. If you're totally unfamiliar with it, that's okay. You don't need to know why it works necessarily. You just want it to do it exactly as we show you. So from here, just navigate to, again, not the data folder, not the project directory. You want to be in this main directory for Design Explorer. In your tree up here, just type CMD and hit enter. And this is going to open your command line, and it'll already be in the directory that it's supposed to be in. If you are familiar with how to operate the command line, you know, yeah, you can open it from wherever and navigate to that folder, but I'm definitely not going to go through how to navigate in the command line. Next, and again, just follow all the instructions we have for you here. Enter the prompt HTTP server. So this is what we have already downloaded from the first tutorial. And what this is going to do is basically it gives you a website. And we're going to copy and paste this into Chrome. But it's a website that's hosted locally, so it's a little strange. Now, you can click on it, and it will automatically add this /#!! But there's no data here. And this is because we've launched it from the Design Explorer folder. So what we need to do is enter a little bit of text to tell it which of these directories it's supposed to be looking for. And what we've done is, so this is all here, so you copy and paste this URL and hit enter, and then you need to add this guy here. So you need it, you need to add in particular the ? set equals and then the name of your directory. So, ? set equals, and then the name of my directory is tutorial. And again, all lowercase, we go over this in the instructions. Where do we say it? Well, we go over it in common issues, but I'll get to that in a moment. So what you should see, this looks terrible on my laptop. I apologize. The display settings are all screwed up, so you can barely see it, but hopefully it looks better on your machine. You'll have a whole bunch of images up here. They should look exactly like mine. If you click on them, you still still can't see it at all because of my crummy display settings. But you've got your parallel coordinates plot down here, and you can see the relationship between all of the inputs over here and the outputs over here. And this gets to the labeling that we went over in the last tutorial and the need to have the correct labeling here, the in colon, out colon. What Design Explorer will do is organize all of your inputs over here on one side of the plot and all of your outputs over here. And it will be no shock to you guys to realize that if we want to see the largest volumes here, they're all going to correspond to the largest footprint, the largest array, and the largest height. And I guess this, our second best option here has five as the value for array, but still has the largest footprint and the largest height. So that makes sense, right? If we wanted to see the smallest volumes, we would find that we have low footprints. The other thing we can do, we can sort by, you just can't see this on my machine, I apologize. I should be working off of a larger monitor, but you can basically change how they're sorted so that you can sort. We can also make this a little bit smaller here. So this guy here, the smallest volume, as you would expect, has the smallest footprint, the smallest array, and the smallest height. And because we were not too creative in our metrics, these all correspond pretty much. The lowest average volume is also the lowest minimum volume and the lowest maximum volume. Okay, so this has launched correctly, which means everything's working. And if this works for you, then you are all set. For Design Explorer, you can change, you can move this around, you can reset it, et cetera, et cetera. But if this has not worked for you, if it is not yet party time, that's fine. Here are a couple of common issues. One, nothing will work if you did not save your directory to the C drive and instead are on a networked drive. Again, at the office, we have all of these different drives. You need to make sure that you are on the C drive. If you've updated the files, but for some reason you're not seeing those changes in Design Explorer, so let's say, I've run out, instead of 200 iterations, I've run out an additional 200, so now I have 400, and I've added them to the directory, and I've relaunched Design Explorer, I've closed the window, and I've gone back and opened the command prompt and launched HTTP server, and I'm still only seeing this 199. That's because you are still operating in a web browser, and you probably need to clear your cache. So I'll show you how to do that really quick. If you right-click anywhere in the window and go to Inspect, this will open up the console, which is probably overwhelming and confusing because you guys are not web designers, and that's totally fine. If you go under this network tab, you want to click disable cache. And what this does is, as long as you have the console open, the cache will be disabled. And when you refresh, it will not draw from the cached information, but will draw instead from the source code. And that should solve that problem. You can close the console. You'll have to refresh Design Explorer again to get the plot to stretch across the screen, but that should fix that issue. Also, other problems you can have. You should have only lowercase or alphanumeric characters in your directory name. So tutorial, I guess this is a bad example. Maybe when you're hosting locally, maybe this won't be an issue for you guys. Maybe you can use capital letters when you're hosting on a website, and which means that you guys should just play it safe and follow this as well. Just keep it all lowercase. White space means that like if I had here we go. If I had like tutorial space one, that space is called white space, and that is your enemy in computer science. So you could put underscore. You pretty much just use an underscore, or you can have, no space at all, just tutorial one. Do not have any white space. That will screw up Design Explorer. It will get confused. That's because of how it's trying to read the directory. It doesn't know what to do with the space. And yeah, lastly, we've already gone over this, but if your features in your data.csv are not clearly labeled with in colon or out colon, it can get confused, and that can screw up Design Explorer as well. But if you've done all of those things, it should load just fine. You should see all the images up here and all of your plots down here, and you should be rocking and rolling. Okay, that's it. Just email us if you have any questions. We'll see you in class, and we'll do some desk crits and help sessions next week as well. All right, cheers.